I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Hi, I'm Mort Cooper, your host on Change Your Voice, Change Your Life. I deal with problems that are considered hopeless, incurable. That position is maintained by Dr. Paul Flint, Johns Hopkins Medical Center, renowned, famed. He tells patients there are no cures. It's manageable, but no cures. I report cures of the condition. The medical profession, world round, on its websites, in writing, guarantee there are no cures. I report cures of spasmodic dysphonia for 35 years. I have peer review in 1980 by the International Association of Logopedics and Phoniatrics, Voice and Speech. I continue to turn out cures of spasmodic dysphonia, recoveries and improvements, but I emphasize the fact that cures underscore the fact that the medical profession is on the wrong road. I'm on a road not taken, not less taken, not taken. I believe, and I find, that the strangled voice, the medical mystery, is not a mystery. It's solved by direct voice rehabilitation, which is all natural. Recently, on August 19th, 2008, Medical Mysteries ABC TV ran this presentation. Take a listen.
For some reason, didn't want to talk. But Ken says he'd do anything to speak normally again. So today, he's hoping ear, nose, and throat specialist Dr. Paul Flint will finally give him a correct diagnosis.
And so we're looking at the at your voice box now.
It was obvious when he came in that he had spasmodic dysphonia.
Spasmodic dysphonia, otherwise known as strangled voice. You likely haven't heard of it unless you're one of the 30,000 Americans who suffer from it. Doctors believe it's caused when part of the brain misfires, the same part that causes Parkinson's.
Spasmodic dysphonia is a neurological condition that affects a patient's voice, and it does so by creating abnormal tension within the throat muscles when they're trying to speak.
I really did have a sense of tremendous relief to know after all that time what it is, that it's manageable.
Manageable, but Dr. Flint says incurable. So how does he recommend treating it? Of all things, Botox. That's right, botulinum toxin, that same poison used to paralyze facial muscles and erase those furrowed brows and wrinkles, can apparently bring back.
On my website, voice-doctor.com, you can get a free copy of Curing Hopeless Voices. Read it, not paying a cent. If you're interested in reading about it as well, you can go to the library and get a copy of Stop Committing Voice Suicide, which on the cover says, the medical mystery of spasmodic dysphonia has been solved by direct voice rehabilitation, all natural. The medical profession maintains, it's well-intentioned, that spasmodic dysphonia is a neurological problem. My answer is very simple, poppycock. The medical profession has never reported a single cure since Traub first described the condition 1871 as nervous hoarseness for over 135 years. Not one single cure, any approach medically. The issue seems to be that the medical profession has a paradigm, and it maintains that paradigm despite the fact that they know, they have been told. I have sent 14,300 ear, nose, and throat doctors, that's the number in this country, information documenting cures of spasmodic dysphonia. I have sent them a DVD, a two-hour DVD, before and after, documenting cures of spasmodic dysphonia. The spasmodic dysphonia is diagnosed by medical people and top academicians who are experts in spasmodic dysphonia. The Mayo Clinic, Arnie Aronson, an icon in my field, diagnosed severe spasmodic dysphonia for Reverend James Johnson over 20 years ago. Hopeless. Dr. Johnson had 1 month of intensive therapy with me, and he has been cured for over 20 years. Dr. Arnie Aronson verifies it and says, Reverend James Johnson's voice is perfect, and it has been perfect for over 20 years. Let's take a listen to cures of spasmodic dysphonia that the medical profession, the American Speech Language Hearing Association, which I'm a member, Allegan, and its association, the National Spasmodic Dysphonic Association, which it funds basically with a generous grant of money, all maintain and guarantee in writing there are no cures of spasmodic dysphonia. You're going to listen to Before and After, listen carefully, of Cures of Spasmodic Dysphonia by Direct Voice Rehabilitation, all natural. Change your voice, you can change your life. Let's listen.
And I took around
this young lady, Gail, was diagnosed at UCLA Medical Center by Dr. Gerald Burke.
And it's spasmodic dysphonia. To feel good, but the voice has been a mess ever since.
I'm commission sales at Sears, and
she's been cured for over 14 years by direct voice rehabilitation, all natural.
I got so depressed, just not being able to talk, that it definitely affected my life.
This voice was coming.
Diagnosed by a staff member in the throat doctor, UCLA Medical Center, with spasmodic dysphonia.
Therapy with Dr.
New voice.
I was using my voice again to the extent that I could go out on interviews and auditions, and shortly thereafter actually worked.
You can hear
diagnosed
the
UCLA Medical Center had a neck division with spasmodic dysphonia.
This is the new voice.
There is that aspect of lightening up, but there also is an aspect of having the correct pressurization.
And he said, diagnosed by a member of the head and neck division staff.
You talk in your regular voice. I said, but when I talk in my regular voice, you can't understand what I'm saying.
I had a strangled voice. It was very difficult to speak. When I did speak, it sounded strangled.
Before I had worked,
diagnosed by a member of the staff, UCLA Medical Center, with spasmodic dysphonia cured.
And he continued to make overtures.
Okay, to pick her up before too late and take her home. Do I feel that I'm likely to go back to it? No, I don't.
Diagnosed at the Mayo Clinic with spasmodic dysphonia.
How long have you had this condition?
All Botox shots failed.
And he says, well, Ron,
new voice.
I'll
he's
give
been
you three
cured
options,
for a
too.
Of time.
Says, well, you can continue coming here
by
for
direct
shots.
Voice rehabilitation, all natural.
Call that doctor in California to schedule a surgery, if you'd like. And then he goes, oh, by the way, Ron, there's also this other guy. Go to his website, and he wrote down his name, thevoicedoctor.com, and handed it to him. And he says, check out this guy. He says he has a cure.
And
diagnosed UCLA Medical Center, head and neck division with spasmodic dysphonia.
That people with focal dysphonia, but very often spasmodic dysphonia. And they call it, you know, multifocal dysphonia.
And I, as a patient who has experienced the fear and agony of thinking that my voice is disappearing.
It just got really bad lately.
Diagnosed by a staff member, UCLA head and neck division.
My voice chokes up, I can't breathe. I feel like I'm running out of air.
By direct voice rehabilitation.
I didn't think that it could be new so voice. Simple, but it was.
Diagnosed with spasmodic dysphonia.
When the
new voice cured for a period
of
years
now. Act like a prism and form a rainbow.
Diagnosed UCLA Medical Center, Dr. Paul Ward, former chair of the head and neck division with spasmodic dysphonia.
Within a matter of days, it would occur.
This is the patient's recovered voice.
And then I'd go in and start talking to my boss, and at the end of like a sentence, it would start dropping, and he'd say, "What's wrong with your voice?" And I'd say, "I don't know."
I thought, "What's happened? What have I done to myself? I know no one out there has this horrible problem I've got, but I found out there's an awful lot of people walking around out there in this world that have the spastic dysphonia."
Diagnosed UCLA Medical Center, Head and Neck Division, USC. Head and Neck Division, SD. New voice. Cured.
It's pretty tragic, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty tragic sound, and it's quite different now.
The last time
diagnosed with spasmodic dysphonia, treated
with
Botox, UCLA Medical Center.
Each and Botox. I completely lost my voice for 6 weeks. I was incapacitated. It was a complete roller coaster going through that, you know, but that's the only treatment that they told me was available and that I would be getting these injections for the rest of my life.
Couldn't think of any name. My sister and I were joking around about
medical center
how many people call the rabbits caught
tail. And spasmodic I said, oh, yeah, wouldn't that be if I called it Q-tip? So we just called it Q-tip.
Can you talk with the rabbit again?
Hi, Q-tip. How are you?
This young lady has been cured of spasmodic dysphonia for over 9 years. By direct voice.
Why are you thirsty? Why did you bite my shoe?
Do you realize you change your voice when you talk to the rabbit?
Yes. I talked higher.
Who diagnosed it?
Scripps Hospital in La Jolla. Probably about a year and a half ago. They told me that it was neurological and I was born with it.
Other than the one time from...
Diagnosed by the top ear, nose, and throat doctors.
I believe that spasmodic dysphonia is curable.
According to legend,
tried 17 Botox shots, only the first worked.
People look, but no one ever finds it. I've been here for the past 10 days.
Diagnosed by Hans von Leyden, one of the top ear, nose, and throat doctors in the country, with spasmodic dysphonia cured for over 30 plus years by direct force rehab. Diagnosed with spasmodic dysphonia abductor adductor. University of Michigan had an exhibition.
They didn't know what to do, because they couldn't get me out of it. Bowed vocal cords after two Botox shots. So
cured of
SD
for over 9 years by direct voice rehabilitation.
Who told me I had
to the transition from
dysphonia.
The voice step by step to the new voice.
It's very difficult because you can't communicate the problem.
This is a transition.
Just
to the final stage.
They want you to go to a psychiatrist, and how are you supposed to go to a psychiatrist when you can't speak?
Well, and then he said, well, how long ago did you see Dr. Cooper? Oh, my God, it's been 6 years. It'll be 6 years in June.
Diagnosed by Dr. Dan Trong, one of the famed doctors.
I remember
one Botox shot lost his voice for over 6 months. Has a new voice, talks about it. Diagnosed at the Mayo Clinic by Dr. Arne Aronson, an icon in the field, with spasmodic dysphonia neurological. It's hard to understand what he's saying. You'll hear the new voice shortly. Cured of SD for over 20 years, confirmed by Dr. Arne Aronson.
By sharing others too, will find
new
hope for a life that allows them that greatest gift that God has given us, the gift that makes us human, that gift we call communication.
We're back in studio. I'm going to play the August 19th Medical Mystery program on ABC TV again for you briefly. Dr. Paul Ward, well-intentioned, maintains, as do other ear, nose, and throat doctors, famed, bright, the best in their field, articulate, who maintain spasmodic dysphonia is a neurological problem, something wrong in the brain. My take is it's not so. It's the misuse of the voice that's causing spasmodic dysphonia. You talk down here. And the medics are not trained, nor are the people in my field basically trained, to understand that you can change your voice, you can change your life by putting your voice up in the face where all good and great voices are. In a library, you can look at a book called Change Your Voice, Change Your Life, 12 Years with HarperCollins. It talks about when you change your voice, you can change your life. If you have spasmodic dysphonia, you can still find a normal voice if you're directed competently and putting your voice up in the face, away from the lower throat. The medical profession has a number of theories. Let me tell you about them. They believe that spasmodic dysphonia, the strangled voice, is caused by a neurological problem, something wrong in the brain, a chemical imbalance in the brain. They believe it's gene-related. They believe it's a disease, a dystonia. They believe it's out of control. They maintain there are no cures. They guarantee it on their website in the United States and worldwide. On medical mysteries, they maintain there are 30,000 patients with this condition. The National Spasmodic Dysphonic Association, which is funded basically by Allergan, the maker of Botox, maintains there are 30,000 people with the condition. They initially maintained on their masthead there are 550,000 down to 50,000. They're now down to 30,000 to make it an arcane problem. It is not arcane. It is out there. It's possibly 1% of the population. So if you have the strangled voice and you're told it's hopeless, it's incurable, think again. Look at the literature. Check out my website and see. It has my book, Curing Hopeless Voices, with Dr. John Curtis, my co-author, talking about the problems in the medical world in treating spasmodic dysphonia and ignoring, if not demonizing, cures of spasmodic dysphonia, which I report for over 35 years. There's something wrong with what's going on, and you're not given the choice of treatment. You're not told direct voice rehabilitation is reporting cures, recoveries, and improvements. There are over 50 cures, I report, of spasmodic dysphonia. I cannot report a cure of spasmodic dysphonia if it's neurological, if it's gene-related, if it's a dystonia, if it's a chemical imbalance in the brain. If it's any one of those factors, and I don't deal with it on a psychiatric basis, if you have the strangled voice, you get a psychiatric problem, you become emotional. Dr. Paul Moses wrote a book, The Voice of Neurosis, some years ago, and he said voice problems are due to neurosis. No, you get a neurosis if you can't talk, and if you get a strangled voice. Dessa Weiss, a famed psychiatrist in New York City, wrote in 1971 in Functional Dysphonia, his book, anyone making any inroads on the strangled voice, spasmodic dysphonia, is achieving an Olympic outcome. I report cures of spasmodic dysphonia. I hope that fulfills Dessa Weiss's definition of an Olympic achievement. Cures, however, are not acceptable to the medical profession. They're not acceptable to Allergan, the maker of Botox, nor to its funded 501c, the National Spasmodic Dysphonic Association. Medical Mysteries refers to the NSDA for those who have spasmodic dysphonia. They do not refer to my website, which reports cures of spasmodic dysphonia, nor to the book, Curing Hopeless Voices, which is free on my website. And also, there's another attribute to all of this, to find out what's going on in the medical profession with the Allergan position and with academia, ASHA. Recently, they banned my ads in the American Speech and Hearing Association. They banned my ads in California Speech and Hearing Association. My position is very clear. They are trying to keep cures from the public, from ASHA, and from those who have spasmodic dysphonia, not giving them a choice of treatment. Let's take a listen, if we have a moment or two, to what the Medical Mystery Program said August 19th, 2008.
Loss of voice was psychological. Doctors believe people suffering from it, for some reason, didn't want to talk. But Ken says he'd do anything to speak normally again. So today, he's hoping ear, nose, and throat specialist Dr. Paul Flint will finally give him a correct diagnosis.
And so we're looking at your voice box now.
It was obvious when he came in that he had spasmodic dysphonia.
Spasmodic dysphonia, otherwise known as strangled voice. You likely haven't heard of it unless you're one of the 30,000 Americans who suffer from it. Doctors believe it's caused when part of the brain misfires, the same part that causes Parkinson's.
Spasmodic dysphonia is a neurological condition that affects a patient's voice. And it does so by creating abnormal tension within the throat muscles when they're trying to speak.
I really did have a sense of tremendous relief to know after all that time what it is, that it's manageable.
Manageable? But Dr. Flint says incurable. So how does he recommend treating it? Of all things, Botox. That's right, botulinum toxin, that same poison used to paralyze facial muscles and erase those furrowed brows and wrinkles, can apparently bring back your voice.
Generally what will happen is the voice...
It brings back your voice on a temporary basis. It paralyzes the vocal cord. On page 15 of the book, Curing Hopeless Voices, I present the outcomes of Botox for patients who are diagnosed with SD. 45 Botox shots at the Mayo Clinic for this young lady. In 15 years, not one ever took. A young man diagnosed at Vanderbilt had 14 Botox shots, not one took, basically. Came to my office, he had another Botox shot, UC San Francisco, no voice at all, over 4 years. He's cured of his spasmodic dysphonia by direct voice rehabilitation. Another patient diagnosed at Vanderbilt, Botox, came to my office. He's cured of spasmodic dysphonia. A young lady diagnosed at UC San Francisco with severe spasmodic dysphonia, tried Botox, didn't work. She tried direct voice rehabilitation. She's cured of spasmodic dysphonia. Took 1 month of intensive therapy. Spasmodic dysphonia is curable. Join with me. It is curable because I'm changing the approach. I use all natural direct voice rehabilitation. Speech therapy does not do what I do. I'm the only doctor in the world reporting cures of spasmodic dysphonia. It's a very, very thrilling experience, but it's a lonely area. I wish those who practice speech therapy would understand what I'm doing. I've been invited to UC San Francisco upcoming October 17th, the year 2008, to show speech therapists and ear, nose, and throat doctors what I'm doing. I have an hour and a half to present that. I'll bring patients who are cured of spasmodic dysphonia to the meeting as well. Spasmodic dysphonia is not incurable. Dr. Paul Ward knows that. One of his patients was diagnosed with it by him. He said it's incurable. She's been cured. Another patient diagnosed by Dr. Gerald Burke, UCLA Medical Center, head and neck chairman, diagnosed her. She's been cured for over 14 years by direct voice rehabilitation. He confirms the cure. The problem is the medical profession remains stuck with a paradigm that's not working. They're on the wrong road. My treatment is very simple, it's very natural, and it echoes what I wrote in the book 1984, Change Your Voice, Change Your Life, which is now in the 20th printing. You can get it in the library. You can get parts of it on my website. The issue is, why can one doctor, only one doctor in the world, unbelievably so, report ongoing cures, recoveries of spasmodic dysphonia, improvements as well, by a simple, non-invasive, non-medical approach called direct voice rehabilitation? Read about it, listen to the cures, make up your own mind. The one problem I find with the medical profession in my field, academia, the American Speech Language Hearing Association, is they do not afford choice of treatment. They will tell you to have speech therapy that guarantees that, in writing, not a single cure ever. They will tell you to try Botox that never reports a single cure by Botoxing vocal cords. It's temporary. It has serious downside effects. There are problems with it. My suggestion is try it, see if it works for you. A number of patients email me, call me, and tell me it hasn't worked for them. So they're ready for direct voice rehabilitation. If we have a few moments left, we can begin once again to record and play what Dr. Paul Flint has said at Johns Hopkins Medical Center. It's a neurological problem, and it's incurable. And I tell Dr. Flint and the medical profession and my colleagues in the medical world, I served on the faculty and staff UCLA Medical Center for 8 years. That's wrong. He's on the wrong road. There are cures. Let's take a listen to it and then run the program to a conclusion with the scream, which is my feeling about what's going on in the treatment of spasmodic dysphonia. Can we run that segment from Medical Mysteries and listen to Dr. Paul Flint?
Strangled, literally choking on his own words. A strange and isolating condition that began after what seemed like normal laryngitis.
When the laryngitis went away, the voice didn't come back.
I couldn't talk normally for over a year. You know, I still don't talk normally.
And that's how I sounded.
An unimaginable loss for National Public Radio host Diane Rehm.
I was interviewed by Diane Rehm, and I told her she's going to lose her voice when she interviewed me twice.
What is this woman doing on the air?
And this radio host and the cartoonist are not alone. Ken Michael's voice is vanishing as well.
There are days and there are times of days and there are circumstances when I can hardly make a sound.
Ken's wife, Raisheen.
His voice sounds tremendously different.
Ken has spent years searching for an answer and a cure.
My physician first thought it was probably reflux. Then he sent me to an ENT specialist, and then he referred me to a gastroenterologist.
These patients are talking in a lower throat, and they have no awareness of putting your voice up in the face. They don't know they can change it. The medical field says they have a dystonia, which means you cannot change. It's a neurological problem. I don't find that to be true.
Want to talk. But Ken says he'd do anything to speak normally again. So today, he's hoping ear, nose, and throat specialist Dr. Paul Flint will finally give him a correct diagnosis.
And so we're looking at your voice box now. It was obvious when he came in that he had spasmodic dysphonia.
Spasmodic dysphonia, otherwise known as strangled voice. You likely haven't heard of it unless you're one of the 30,000 Americans who suffer from it. Doctors believe it's caused when part of the brain misfires, the same part that causes Parkinson's.
Spasmodic dysphonia is a neurological condition that affects a patient's voice. And it does so by creating abnormal tension within the throat muscles when they're trying to speak.
I really did have a sense of tremendous relief to know after all that time what it is, that it's manageable.
Manageable, but Dr. Flint says incurable. So how does he recommend treating it? Of all things, Botox. That's right, botulinum toxin, that same poison used to paralyze facial muscles and erase them.
All right, we're back in studio. Diane Rehm of NPR Radio is a very fine interviewer. She interviewed me after I wrote Change Your Voice, Change Your Life. At the end of the program, she asked me when the interview was going on about her voice. I told her she's committing voice suicide. Later on, I did a book called Voice Suicide, and she was losing her voice then. She says Advil caused a problem and God is sending her a message, perhaps. But I say it's misuse of the voice, and she's been misusing her voice for a while. This is Johnny Cash singing I Walk the Line on the screen, my screen concept. Thank you for joining with me on Change Your Voice.
I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine, I walk the line. I find myself alone when each day's through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you.